Welcome to lesson number 6. In this lesson, we are going to talk about a very special feature named SubForm. The SubForm exists in order to give me, as the business owner, the ability to grab from my clients dynamic information. Let's assume that I have an investment form and I like to ask my clients what are their investments. One client will have 5 investments, while the other client will have 0 or maybe 1. If I need to create this questionnaire, this form, without the subform, it will look something like that. I will need to grab here a single line and I will name it investment 1. And then I will have another field named currency, and I will write here value 1, and then I will need to grab another one, and I will name it investment 2, and then I will grab another currency and I will name it value 2. And let's say that most of the people will have about 10 investments. I will need to create 10 fields like that. Now, that's a waste of time, and it's also a waste of fields, because later on, when we are going to integrate our Zoho form with Zoho CRM, you will see that Zoho CRM is limited in how many fields you can have, which means if I'm going to play around with those small fields, it means that I'm going to exhaust all the fields from Zoho CRM, and it doesn't make sense. If I want to make it in a nice way, I will need to use a subform. Now, let me just delete this garbage, 1 second. Now, I will go to the advanced fields, and I will grab a subform, and I will just drop it. Whenever I will drag and drop a subform, you can see that it opened a subform, right? I will grab a single line. I will name it investment name, and I will grab a currency field, and I will write here investment value. And now I'm going to save it. Now, if I'm going to access the form, you can see that I have something like that. And I will have investment number 1. And if I click on the plus button, I can have investment number 2. And maybe investment number 3. Once I will submit the form, I will get all this information to my Zoho CRM, which is very cool. Or if you like, you can just get all this information as a PDF. So that really was the subform. It's not a big lesson, but it's a very important one. In the next lesson, we are going to start working on the different settings. There are lots of different settings in Zoho forms. I am not going to go over all of them, but I will show you the main ones, the ones that will really make a difference in your day-to-day operations. So thank you very much for watching the subform. I hope you will use it. If you like this lesson or maybe the previous lessons, drop me a nice like so I will continue. I have the energy to try to give you lots of value. And if you like to get more of what I'm doing, maybe click on the subscribe button or the bell to get notifications on future videos. Thank you very much for watching this session. I will see you at the next lesson.